Hi, I'm John Taylor. Welcome to my Stone Love Bass Odyssey. It's where we look at the evolution of a song from the perspective of the bass man. Today, it's Some Like It Hot. After the labor and drama of making Duran Duran's third album, Andy and I vowed to make some music with a more organic feel. The Power Station began when we connected with chic drummer Tony Thompson on David Bowie's Serious Moonlight tour. Tony had perfected the art of phenomenal drum breaks. Whenever we were in a club and Diana Ross's I'm Coming Out came on, we'd all go crazy. This is Signature Tony. I floated the idea of a project to Tony, who was immediately enthusiastic. His drum idol was John Bonham from Led Zeppelin, which surprised me, so he was ready to rock out. He suggested we invite Bernard Edwards along as producer. We gave the project the working title Big Brother. We imagined using different singers on different songs and made plans to write some new material in addition to recording a cover of the T-Rex classic Get It On. Like a car, you got a hubcap, diamond star halo. If you're like a car, out, yeah. Andy and I began with a studio session in Paris. When I arrived, he'd already programmed up some drums and keyboards to get us started. I started to play. Something like... Some Like It Hot was born. We wanted to put Tony in the spotlight, and we suggested a big drum intro to this as yet unnamed groove, similar to I'm Coming Out, but on steroids. We want to multiply. You can hear me playing fast percussive strums using a pick, or a plectrum if you're from England. The verse groove has me experimenting with the bass slapping style, which involves using the thumb of the right hand to hit the strings, but the left hand also has a particular way of responding. Go to a C major chord for the bridge. Feel the heat. Let's string them together. Became friends after he came to an early Duran show at a New York club. I'd always found him interesting. He had a restless, progressive muse and excellent taste in musicians and producers. He never made the same album twice. We invited Robert to a studio session, having asked him to sing over one of the Big Brother tracks. By the time he left that night, we'd formally asked him to be the singer in the band. Tony, meanwhile, has moved the drum groove along in a crazy way, giving it an almost salsa feel. Roger Taylor came in and played the perfect timbale, and I pushed the bass line. Drum intro, killer verse vibe, bridge, and a chorus, an ABC structure. To get the lyric, I have to go to the Bahamas. But that's how it was in the 80s.
Nassau's gone funky, Nassau's gone soul.
When I arrived in Nassau, we had a title. When I left, we had a lyric. Oh, and that name for the project, Big Brother, that was replaced by a new name, The Power Station.
I know you're qualified. Are you gonna do it?
The only time that Tony, Robert, Andy and I performed together, and we made for a curious enterprise. I often wish we'd played together more than we did. We lost Tony and Bernard and Robert and engineer extraordinaire Jason Cassaro. We miss them, but they live on in the grooves they created and the awesome sound that is the Power Station. There's a nice coda to Some Like It Hot where we change the second chord from a C to an A. Thanks for taking the journey with me. Join me on Instagram Live, where I'll be chatting with the legend, the man with the rebel yell, Billy Idol. Nassau's gone funky. Nassau's got soul.